Hello, everyone, and welcome to 2020. It's hard to believe this whole brand new year and decade is beginning, and it definitely feels like there is massive clearing energy as we prepare for all of the amazing things that are unfolding in the next decade. And I wanted to bring you this video today all about your personal year energy so that you could leverage that awareness with the universal energy that's happening for the year of 2020. Which will help set you up for success. You can also come back to this video and watch this for future years. So for 2021, 2022, the same thing will be true. You'll just need to alter the information a little bit for the year that we're in then. We're always moving in a nine-year cycle. And right now in that nine-year cycle, we're in the energy of the number four universally. So we've gone through, in the beginning of our cycle, of our nine-year cycle, we've been in a one, a two, and a 3 year, and we're now ready for this incredible 4 year. And then we'll continue to progress those numbers. We go through the five, the six, the seven, the eight, and the nine, and then we'll begin a new cycle again just before the next decade. But this decade is sure to be packed with an amazing number of changes, exciting new developments in technology, and all kinds of things happening for ourselves personally, the expansion of consciousness. There's so many radical shifts. This is definitely going to be a decade of radical change. So first, some radical clarity, and then radical change as we move towards the coming years. We start this decade in a 4 year, which I think is quite significant because that four energy is all about structure, stability, safety, foundation. It means we have the opportunity really to emancipate ourselves from the past and begin something that is stronger and more functional than what we had in the past. And that can be on all levels of our life, individually, and of course, collectively. So how does this impact you individually? Well, one of the things that I love to look at as a numerologist, and there are lots of different things to look at, but when we look at years, we can get a good sense of what the karmic pattern is that you're leaning into, what kinds of things you'll be clearing, and what kinds of things you're calling in. So the karmic pattern is based on your own personal cycle. It's a really easy calculation. There's a lot of different ways this fits into the other aspects of numerology. We won't go into that in this video. We'll keep it really simple. So first you look at your year energy. To calculate that, it's very simple. If you'll just trust me and do the calculation, I'm not going to give you any background knowledge on why that is, but the year energy is the addition of your month, your day, and the current year. So for everyone, the year is going to be the number four. We're going to add the number four to your day of birth and your month of birth. We're not using your year of birth for any of this calculation. So I'll give you an example. My birthday is June 1st. So that's a six and a one added to the four. So six plus one is seven, and add that to the four, right? So seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. I'm in a 2 year. The reason I'm in a 2 year is because the double digits break down. 11 becomes two ones. Those ones are added together and it's a two. So let's take your date of birth. So depending on when you were born, if you have a double digit month, if you were born in December, for example, then your first month calculation would be a one plus a two. You would break the December energy down into the number three. Your day that you were born, if you were born on the 22nd, for example, we would take those twos and add them together to get four. So we have, I should probably get a pen and make this easier on myself instead of trying to do the math in my head while I'm recording the video. So for our sample, we would have three plus four plus four. So eight, nine, 10, 11. So also a two here. So do that for yourself now. You can pause this video and just take your month, your day, and the current year number four and add that together to get your year number. And this is just going to tell you your personal cycle. Okay, welcome back. Hopefully you've got that all calculated and it makes sense. If you have any questions, please post a question below the video or send me a message through social media and I can help you with that. It's no big deal. So sometimes there can be questions about certain days and certain things and what if I was born on the cusp and lots of little, that's okay. If you have a question, just post that. All right. So let's dive into what your personal year is reflecting for you. So we're going to go in order and we're going to look at 1 through 9 and how that is impacting you. So if you are, and I'll put some timestamps here so you can jump right to your year number if you want. But if you are in a year number 1, so if you did all of your calculations and you got a 10 or something else, then it brings you down to a 1. So that 1 energy is all about new starts. It's about the beginnings of things. It's about rebirthing and receiving and allowing things into your experience. So that 1 energy means that this year you're going to have the desire to lean into new things, to begin new things. You're also going to be clearing away things that no longer serve you if you have things that you're doing that you shouldn't be or don't want to be doing. Things that don't match where you're going. So if you have this great idea to start a business this year and you're working a job or you don't have enough time because you have all these other activities, then some of those activities are going to be shed so that you can make space for the new business. So that's a really simplistic explanation. This can be releasing of people and friends. You'll notice the same thing happens in a 9 year when we get there. But in that 1 year, you're making way for new ideas. You're open and receiving new information. You're receiving new feedback from people, new revenue. Income is coming from surprising places. Insights are coming from surprising places. You have the desire to do things that maybe you didn't even think that you wanted to do. You have a lot of inspiration. So it's a great year to be really open. Be open to receive new information. Be open to change your mind about things. Be open to restart, to rebirth, to completely shed what you were doing and lean into something new. This is a great year for taking a risk on something that you're like, I don't know, I've always wanted to start this thing or do this something. This is the year to begin to put those plans into action. Now, you don't need to bring this to fruition. You don't need to be successful at it. You don't need to, at the end of the year, have done it all. In fact, by the end of the year, the goal of the energy is that you have clarity of what you're doing next. That's the main goal. It's not that you have clarity as you go into the year. It's that you allow this year to give you the clarity of knowing where you're going next. So if you've been working in something for a number of years, or you've been in a relationship for a number of years, and you feel like it's time to make a change, then trust that nudge to make a change and begin exploring the change. So beautiful, beautiful energy. If you get too far down the road, you can sometimes sabotage the energy of receiving new insights. Sometimes you need to let things percolate, that things make sense, so that towards the end of the year, come September, you have a better idea. Towards the end of the year, as you get ready for 2021, you'll have a better idea of what you're bringing into the next year. Now, the 4 energy is going to get you to really think about this from a foundational perspective. Is my idea worthy, viable? Can I bring this into the world? You'll want to have structure and you'll want to be committed to that idea. So by the end of the year, you'll want to have a really strong commitment that no matter what, you're going to follow through with this new idea. And I promise you will have a new idea. Even if you've worked at the same place for 20 years, this 1 energy is saying you're going to have a new idea this year. And this might be personal, might be professional, but whatever that new idea is, you want to trust and follow it. If you do not trust and follow it, that's when things start to go haywire. You'll hear that for all of the numbers. When you don't trust the nudge of what's coming, then your health and your life and the circumstances around you begin to kind of go all out of sync, and you feel the consequences of not following through with your vision, with what's coming forward for you. All right, for a 2 energy year, this is all about connection. It's about connection, devotion, and commitment to your higher self or your connection with spirit. So it's about being connected at a relational level from human to human. So the people in your world, whether that's friends, lovers, children, family, those connections will become under the radar. That's something that will become very important to you. That's something that I'm going to be paying attention to, is those connections, the physical connections and the not so physical connections, the connection you have with source, the divine, God, whatever that relationship is defined as for you, that relationship will take on a new dynamic. You'll want to explore it more deeply. So you're going to be focused on these energies as you move throughout the year. Now, the goal of this energy is that by the end of the year, you would take the new idea from last year and you would help rearrange all of the people and connect with all of the people who can support you. So there may be people in your world that maybe aren't quite matching the new vision, new idea. They'll kind of fall away and new people may come in. Connection with spirit. If you need a stronger intuitive connection to bring your vision to reality, then that will unfold this year. Whatever those connections are, those will be developed, and a devotion to those connections is very important. And then of course, love. Love is a big part of the two energies. So loving yourself, loving others. So that will become a focus of attention. What does love look like? And is that in relationship? Is that in an intimate partnership? Is that in friendship? Is that your own personal love journey that you're on? Whatever that is, it's going to come under the focus for you so that you can flesh that out and decide so that you have the support you need to fulfill the new vision. Right? Do you see the trend? You have the vision, you have the people to support the vision. Now, of course, it's a 4-year. So that 4-year says, okay, as you're doing this, let's also make sure that everyone around you is helping you feel stable and strong and able to grow. If you don't have people around you who enable your growth, it's going to be very difficult to progress. And so the universe or God is going to help make adjustments to your course and make adjustments to the people around you so that you have more of that stability. Okay. So then we have the 3 energy. Now the 3 energy, as it comes in, is all about expansion. So expansion, this is also self-love. This is about amplifying the energies that you're carrying. It's about speaking your truth. It's about speaking your truth, whether that's individually with people around you or with people on a stage. It can very well move you into the spotlight this year. It's all about entertainment, having fun, playing. That energy can also be about nurturing your own abundance. So living your truth, nurturing your own abundance. Now, what will happen in a 3-year is you'll be inspired to be more abundant by the end of it, right? That's the whole goal, is to activate more abundance into your experience. So if you're not feeling terribly abundant, then you'll notice that the world will want to bring you evidence or help you adjust course in order to feel more abundant. So things will begin to feel unstable in order to bring you into stability. So the 3 energy is like being on a teeter-totter all the time. It's like everything's amazing, everything is frustrating, everything is amazing, everything is frustrating. And you're just kind of going back and forth, back and forth. And it's trying to find a harmonized energy in order to reach stability for the next year. So the goal in this is to lean into the energies of abundance on all sides to see what energies want to be cleared. So you may notice that emotional mastery comes up for you this year, as thoughts and emotions will run rampant. They'll either be bringing you to the amplified experiences that you want or bringing you to the amplified experiences that you don't want. So either way, just notice and allow yourself to change course. Don't take it too personally. It's not trying to punish you. The energy isn't trying to punish you. It's just saying, hey, did you know that you have an abundance of this kind of crazy in your world? Hey, did you know that you have an abundance of all this love and appreciation and all these things over here? Did you know that you have an abundance of money in this bank account you forgot about? Oh, did you realize that you have an abundance of lack thoughts showing up and we need to adjust your mindset? It's going to show you all those things so that it can serve you, so that it can help bring you to that level of stability. So everything is going to be about stabilizing. So not only would you normally be stabilizing into a 4, but you have the 4 energy of 2020 showing up and saying, I really want you to feel stable. And so I may cause you to feel really unstable as you reach the stability. So don't be alarmed if you're in a 3 energy year this year and you feel a lot of instability. It's not permanent. It is a temporary feeling that's helping you make major changes for yourself. So use that as a clue. Go, okay, I feel unstable here. What changes are being called in? It is definitely a gift. All right. Now, if you're moving into a 4-year personally, along with a 4-year universally, holy wow, you're really going to be feeling that desire to get things done, to clear things off your plate, to anchor in stability in all areas of your life to really take action towards the things that maybe you've been thinking about for a long time. Maybe you realized last year that you're like, yeah, I really want to be healthier. And this year you're like, okay, I'm going to take the actions. I'm going to do the things and drink the water and go to the gym and, you know, whatever it is and eat the foods so that I have that. The same thing with business. If you've been wanting a stable, solid, viable business, maybe you'll look at your time allocation and what have you scheduled and what space have you allowed and can you leverage your income and all of these, can you partner with people? All of a sudden, all these ideas in order to stabilize and come to a firm foundation in your business will arise. So it's a beautiful, beautiful energy. And when you're in a four, it means it just intensifies that. If you're in any year at the same time as the universe, it will intensify that experience for you. And guess what? If you're in a four, as a, you have your own, your personal year four, and you're in this universal year four, that means that you're always in the universal energy. It means next year you'll be at a five, and so will the universe. So take that to heart when you realize that you will feel the intensity of what's happening around you, maybe more so than others. So especially if you're an empath, that's even more. But as you're feeling the universal energy, everybody's instability around you, you're going to be feeling more like tenfold. You're going to be feeling that energy as if their instability is your instability. So just noticing that you're going to be extra sensitive to the energies this year, that you're going to be extra sensitive to that four energy. And that's okay. You did this. You created this. You created this plan for yourself so that you would ensure that you were always in sync with what was happening in the world. It's likely because you came here to be in service to the world in a particular way that makes it easier when you're in sync with the needs of the masses. So it will help you understand what they need so that you can provide that for them. It's oftentimes that you can launch new programs and new products, even though it's not a 1 year, it can be the culmination of all the ideas you've been having now land into something really firm and you're able to expand and grow beyond them. So this is an energy of growth. Beautiful, beautiful energy. If you're not feeling the stability, you're feeling the instability. Again, this is about noticing so that you can come into alignment with the harmony and the balance that is intended to occur during this time. This is also a time when finances come under the radar. So you're going to be paying attention to your financial foundation, all of your foundations, your health, your finance, your finances, and your relationships. All of those things really want strong foundation. And if you have one out of sync, you're going to know it this year. And if you've got one trucking along, you're also going to know that. So don't get caught up just in the where it's trucking. Allow yourself to grow in the areas where you don't have as much stability so you can bring yourself into more harmonization. Although by the end of the year, you'll have a clear idea of what things are not stable, what things are, have no chance of growing, and you'll be able to release those in the following year. Okay, but for now, it really is just about stabilizing. If you're in a 6 year, if you're in a six personal year, this is all about foundation in legacy. So thinking about the legacy you're leaving with the world. This is this oversees the relationships you have with your family, your extended family, your immediate family, those you spend time with, the harmonization of that energy, your home. What's how your environment is structured. Oftentimes in a 6 year, people want to move, they want to redecorate, they want to remodel. There's a lot of different energies that happen around bringing the home into focus in a way that feels more in alignment with the energy that you're bringing into the world. Things just don't, they feel stale and stagnant and they don't match anymore. And the six energy wants to harmonize you with all the changes you've made over the last several years. I totally skipped the five energy. So we'll come back to that. I apologize. So the six energy is all about stabilizing what changed in the 5 year. So that six energy will also be about aligning you with your purpose more specifically. Now, your purpose that you'll want to carry out into the world in order to leave a legacy with the world. So maybe that purpose is having a family, having children. Maybe that person's purpose is a business. Maybe that purpose is leaving a legacy of love with everyone around you. Whatever that is, it doesn't have to be a practical paid purpose. Purpose is what you feel pulled and passionate about doing in the world. Everyone is here to do something the being of you wants to create. You are a creator. So this is what follows the energy of the five. So if you're in a five energy year, for some reason I wanted to skip that five energy and I don't know why, but that five energy is all about change. The five wants to do it its own way. So maybe that's why. Five is all about freedom. It's all about interruption, rebellion. It's all about testing the waters in order to reach a higher state of wisdom. It is one of the most teaching energy years you can have. This year is going to teach you the truth. It's going to reveal the truth to you. It's going to feel like it's, you don't always know what's going on. It feels like you're going one direction and then you're going another. There's a lot of course correcting energy. It can feel a little chaotic. All these changes are happening at once. So you oftentimes have, and this is where we're all going in 2021. So we'll go into a place of total dramatic change. So you can expect your world to have a lot of change, a lot of travel. Again, you may be moving in a 5 year as well as a 6 year. 5 year may inspire you to move, and then you move in the 6 year. A five will help you know what you want to clear out. It's the beginning of clearing energies. So the five is, I will no longer tolerate that. I'll no longer tolerate negative thinking, negative talking. I'll no longer tolerate the habits that I have that aren't serving me. I'll no longer tolerate not having the freedom that I want. I'll no longer tolerate lack. It's all about your intolerance and then your desire to create what you want. So replacing energy. Now you can get caught up in what you don't want. And so you want to use that energy as a catapult, if you will. It's the contrast energy that says, ooh, you don't want this because you want this other thing. And so it's a time to get clear again, to adjust course. You've had some stability and you're getting ready to expand, right? It's an expansion energy from that stability of the 4 year. You're expanding into something else. And in that expansion requires movement and change and adjustment and remodeling. So by the end of the year, you should know what you want to change if you haven't already made those changes. This is also a time when relationships come to an end or you have clarity about that. When we leave jobs, when we leave careers, when we leave states or countries or provinces, we make bigger moves during a five energy. We're ready for something that's beyond our comfort zone. It's all about exiting the comfort zone. And also seeing things in a way we have not seen before. So sometimes it's a hard truth energy. Maybe you didn't know you were going to get divorced this year and surprise, or maybe you didn't know you were going to get the job offer to go work in London and surprise. So it's a lot of surprise energy. It's really beautiful, but again, it's a little unpredictable. So don't try to predict anything that's happening if you're in a 5 year. So we talked about the 6 year. The one thing that I will show you around the six energy year is if you wanted to change things in a 5 year and you landed into the 6 year and you're in a 6 year now, you should have a pretty good sense of the things that want to change, the things that you want to bring into harmony. And if you're having a hard time with anything, it means you've got some attachments that you need to navigate. It means you're attached to what was, and you're a little bit afraid of change, even if you don't realize it. A lot of people don't realize they're resistant to change, and they are. So if you're feeling like things are a little sticky and tricky, then you may have some attachments, and see if you are trying to control the outcome or if you're letting things unfold. Okay. Last 3 years, the last 3 year numbers. So the seven energy is all about taking action. It's a fast-paced action energy year. A lot happens, and it usually asks you to take risks or make sacrifices. The sacrifices or risks that you're being asked to make are so that you can learn something new and experiencing something more. This is part of that expansion energy. From 5 to 9, you're in expansion, and then you move into contraction. So 5 to 8, expansion, 9 is contraction. So you're expanding, and then you're restarting, right? So massive expansion over the next several years. So you're in the beginning, you're still in the beginning energy of that. You're taking action, you're learning a lot about what's going to work and what isn't going to work. You are raising your own personal values. So you'll notice that the risks you take and the challenges that you're facing, the sacrifices that you make, are all related to allowing yourself to have more, raising your standards, raising your values about things so that you can experience more. This is all about leaning into more. Sometimes leaning into more, you can stub your toe. Sometimes you can move too quickly. Sometimes you can move into something you don't actually want. So you'll notice that. And so as you move into something, you're leaning in and you're expanding and you reach something you don't want, you're going to get smacked by something that says, ooh, not this. So just notice those things and don't take it as a failure. Go, oh, that's not where I'm expanding this year. Where am I expanding? Move yourself into the other direction. Hint, look for things that feel stable. Look for things that feel secure. Look for things that allow you to feel a greater sense of safety. So not that you're reaching for comfort zone actions, we're expanding, but make sure that you are also feeling the four energy of that, making sure that anything you're expanding is something that can be expanded, right? You reach a point with a balloon where you're blowing up a balloon and it's like getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and you reach a point where it can no longer do that. So you want to make sure that what you are expanding has the capacity to do that, that it has enough legs beneath it or bones within it in order to make that happen. So do pay attention, do be practical in your approach to thinking and feeling your way forward. The 8 year, if you are in an 8 year, you are feeling the double four energy, right? So you're feeling this massive movement towards something. So it's a very physical energy again, and it's an energy that wants you to tap into momentum and speed for the things you've been doing. So ideally, you've been consciously moving through these years. By the time you get to the 8 year, you've let go of things you don't want, you've leaned into your expansion, and now you're doing something you love to do that you're good at. So whatever it is that you've been doing, that your idea from year one, you've now landed into it where you're really good at it. And this is the year you do lots of it, right? So I'll give the example of me becoming a tarot reader 20 years ago and learning to tell tarot, you know, using the cards and learning the system. And by the time I reached that 8 energy, that momentum energy, I was able to do card readings over and over and over and over again, right? The same thing happens with, you know, my level of emotional mastery, with my level, with my coaching business, with, you know, all these things. You acclimate to these skills. So this is an energy of you have acclimated to a skill, and now it's time to repeat it over and over and over again to create a momentum. So if you've been, you know, you built a sales business, for example, this would be the year where you know how to sell it. You've got the systems in place, and now it's just sell it, sell it, sell it, sell it. Get out there and do the thing, right? So you can feel that you are being pulled deliberately to function in a capacity where you're diligently committed to doing what will bring you toward your dream. So if doing a bunch of readings brings you towards your dream, or seeing a bunch of clients brings you towards your dream, then you do that thing. So there's a lot of repetition. Now, it's really important during an 8 year, and always, is to know, am I fulfilling my dream or someone else's? So you can become very uncomfortable in an 8 year if you are doing something for others or for a purpose that's way beyond your own that you don't actually love. So you will notice that if you are overly concerned about other people's opinions and what they think of what you're doing and what they want you to do, then you're probably a little bit out of sync of that 8 energy. This should be something you want to do, that you love it. Even if you work for someone else, you love that you get to do it and you show up every day and you feel the success of it. So you're getting promotions and you're getting bonuses because it feels so amazing. If you're not having the reward from the outside world and you're looking for feedback, and you're hoping for feedback, this is an opportunity to develop your own self-awareness, figure out who you are and what you want, land into some emotional and mental mastery, and then make sure that you're very clear about what you want to take out into the world. It may take you a couple of years to get on track with that, but it's better now than if you wait. So if you can get into alignment, you can tap into this energy. The 8 wants to reward you with lots of financial well-being and lots of abundance. So you want to tap into this with as much awareness of who you are and what you want as possible. So going into an 8 year, if you're going into an 8 year, make sure you really know who you are and what you want and what your goals are and what your skills are and what those things are that you can repeat so that you can benefit from that and receive that, that material and spiritual reward, that fulfilling energy, that fulfillment reward. All right, our last number, Last number is number 9. This is the completion energy. So 9 is all about completing the cycle. So here you've come through the 9-year cycle. You're at your last year. So the 9-year is saying, okay, it's time to clear these cycles. It's time to assess the past. It's time to raise my standards, to get ready for the future, and to say no more to the things that I haven't let go of. So a lot of times what happens in a 9-year is during your 5-year, you get the nudge that you need to make a change. And maybe you make some of those changes, but maybe you don't fully make the change. By the time you get to the 9-year, there's an accountability. Your ideal life is in front of you. There's a possibility of tapping into a highest possible version for you, but it's going to require that you release things that do not match anymore. So we're releasing to create space for what's coming, mentally, emotionally, and physically. So you want to take stock of what mental ideas can I release, what emotions are holding me back, and what physical things am I holding on to in my body and in my life. And that can be people, and think people, places, and things, all the nouns, right, that you're holding on to. And then just preparing for that next cycle. So everything that's happening is about building a pathway, clearing the slate for the new pathway. It isn't about the new pathway yet. You might have an idea what the new pathway is, but you're not going to fully land into it until the 1 year. This is all about clearing, and trust me, you want to clear. You do not want to hold anything back during a 9-year. You want to let yourself be in the release of it and notice any attachments you have and release those attachments. So in a 4-year, that's going to be even more intensified by wanting to be structured, and it's going to be triggering your perfectionism. So if you're in a 9-year, the 4 energy comes in because it's already ideal. That 4 wants to create perfection. So be on the alert. Perfection isn't real, and perfection can sabotage you. Allow yourself to clear the slate so you can be stable and have a good structure and systems in place for the coming years, but don't worry so much about getting it exactly right. Implement the systems, you can get it right over time, but just implement the systems, know what you're doing and how you want to move forward, know what you're clearing, be focused on the clearing more so than on what you're bringing in, so that you can bring in. You're actually creating a vacuum this year. You're releasing to receive. This is the biggest release to receive year that there is. So, all right, whatever year you're in, know that you're going to be triggered by stability, safety, structure, and systems. And hear me. Oh, I want to just send so much love through the broadcast. Safety, security, stability, systems. They're born from a sense of trust within. So everyone on the planet is being nudged to trust. If the planet were to have a word of the year, it would be trust yourself. Trust would be the word for the year. Develop safety and security from within. You can only feel safe when you trust yourself. If you do not trust yourself, you will feel unstable, insecure, unsafe, all the time, because no one outside of you will ever look after all of your needs. Only you will do that. So developing your trust is so important. So no matter what year number you're in, allow yourself space and time to grow that trust. Maybe create a log where you're writing down the things that you think you should be doing and whether or not you trusted it, and then how it turned out if you did or didn't trust that. Allow yourself to develop that. Trust things you wouldn't normally trust. It'll be a big breakthrough year for you if you're able to do that and cultivate that foundation from within. Take care of your body. Take care of your mind. Take care of your heart. And the external world will take care of itself. All right, everyone, have a beautiful January and start to your year, or beautiful day whenever you are tuning in to watch this. And if you have any questions or want to know more about numerology, please reach out. You can email me directly at joy@joykingsborough.com, or you can visit my website, joyandjonah.com, and I'll put those links below the video. Thank you so much, and have a beautiful year. Bye.